Just 10 cents a day helps fund local programs like Scenic Stops, Northwest Ohio Journal, and BGSU Brain Game. Watch, connect, explore.
I'm Rod Noble, I'm the executive director here at the Schedel Arboretum and Gardens, and we're standing in the Japanese garden area. The Schedel Gardens is a hidden gem in Northwest Ohio. It's 17 acres of intensively managed and cared for grounds. We have many varieties of plants, a lot of unusual specimens of trees and shrubs. Among them are dawn redwood trees, Japanese maples, Yoshino cherry trees, and we also plant about 12,000 annuals every year. Schedels were unique people in that, as I mentioned, they didn't have children, they traveled a lot, they loved to collect things, and they collected plants, and they brought back a lot of Japanese maple trees and just some unusual varieties of plant life that you don't see in a lot of different places. This is basically the Schedels' interpretation of the Japanese garden. It includes many of the elements that you would see in such a garden in Japan. The water features that are behind me that you can hopefully hear the water, that's symbolic in the Japanese culture of the mystical passage of time. And you can see over my shoulder a bridge or two, and that's another element that's common in a Japanese garden that symbolizes the transformation from one phase of life to another. And then there's also a red torii gate. They believe that if you pass through a torii gate, you'll be blessed with long life, good health, and prosperity. We have three Yoshino cherry trees. We're grown from cuttings from the Yoshino cherry trees that were given to the United States government by the government of Tokyo back in 1912. And as far as I know, there are only three places outside of Washington, D.C. where those trees have grown, and that would be here, Bowling Green State University, and the governor's mansion in Columbus. We have a rose garden. There are about 100 different varieties of roses that grow on the property. The bonsai shelter is one of my favorite areas. Bonsai wasn't real popular in the United States until after World War II. In Japan, in particular, they're handed down from generation to generation. They'll live for literally hundreds of years. It's with 125 of those miniature plants to look at and watch after and take care of. It's a real rewarding spot in the gardens for me. About 2001, we started to integrate artwork into the garden, specifically sculptures. And the idea was to demonstrate the harmony between nature and the arts. It's actually part of our mission, which is to create life-enhancing experiences for the appreciation of nature and the arts. It's a real popular spot for graduation pictures, prom pictures. In fact, Woodmore High School annually comes here and has a prom parade. It's a real popular spot for weddings and wedding receptions. In 2013, we have 52 weddings scheduled to take place. As part of what we try to provide for those opportunities for the study of nature is a series of workshops every summer. We'll talk about bonsai and how to create and care for bonsai. We'll talk about water gardening, container gardening, all different topics. We provide that life-enhancing experience for the opportunities to study and appreciate nature, particularly with our children. They get most of their stimulus from electronics, and I'm afraid that we're losing touch with nature. So hopefully when people come here and visit, they'll bring their children and expose them to nature where they can learn, and that nature will stay an important part of their lives for a long time to come.
Scenic Stops is brought to you by WBGU-TV. Support great local programming by giving now at WBGU.org/pledge.